Thanks for joining us on the CBN News Channel. I'm Charlene Israel. The race is on. Seven Republican presidential hopefuls faced off for their first presidential debate Monday night in New Hampshire. Topics ranged from the economy to religious freedom to Sharia law. And a big announcement from a Tea Party favorite. David Brody has the story from Manchester.
The night began with a bang as Congresswoman Michelle Bachmann grabbed the spotlight.
I filed today my paperwork to seek the office of the presidency of the United States.
Bachmann joined six others in the debate, but the main target wasn't on stage. He was in the White House.
The Obama administration is an anti-jobs, anti-business, anti-American energy, destructive force.
And as for President Obama's health care law,
I will not rest until I repeal Obamacare. It's a promise. Take it to the bank, cash the check.
Bachmann's announcement and take charge performance caught the attention of mainstream media types.
She is the one candidate, as we've seen, and you've seen it as you've been out, who excites conservative audiences in ways that some of the other sort of established candidates do not.
As for that issue of health care, Mitt Romney found himself defending the plan that he presided over as governor of Massachusetts. It required all individuals to purchase health insurance, something that has been compared to Obama's new health care law.
Ours was a state plan, a state solution.
Tim Pawlenty recently labeled the Massachusetts plan Obamacare.
Using the term Obamacare was a reflection of the president's comments that he designed Obamacare on the Massachusetts health care plan.
As for the big issue of entitlements, the candidates agreed something must be done.
Medicare is going to be cut starting in 2014 by the federal government.
While the economy is the number one voter concern, social issues like faith in the public square attracted a lot of attention.
Congress should never prohibit the expression of your Christian faith in a public place.
On the topic of Islam, Herman Cain had to explain a past statement that he may not be comfortable choosing Muslims to work in his administration.
I would not be comfortable because you have peaceful Muslims and then you have militant Muslims, those that are trying to kill us.
He got a defender in Newt Gingrich.
If you're not prepared to be loyal to the United States, you will not serve in my administration, period.
What about radical Islamic Sharia law being applied as a defense in American courtrooms?
I do not believe in Sharia law in American courts.
We're not going to have Sharia law applied in U.S. courts. That's never going to happen.
On the life issue, Rick Santorum took on the question whether Romney's change from pro-choice to pro-life was believable.
I think an issue should be in looking at any candidate is looking at the authenticity of that candidate and looking at their record over time and what they fought for.
People have had a chance to look at my record. I believe people understand that I'm firmly pro-life.
The GOP candidates are going to do all of this again in just a couple of months out in Iowa. That Republican field at that time could look a lot different. Rudy Giuliani may be in. Governor Rick Perry of Texas may be in as well. And of course, John Huntsman, the former governor of Utah, will definitely be in by that time. And so the economy and the GOP field, very much the same in a state of flux. David Brody, CBN News in Manchester, New Hampshire.
The president promoted his plans to jumpstart job growth in North Carolina Monday. The battleground state has an unemployment rate of 9.7%. Members of Obama's Jobs Council also toured the state, including senior advisor Valerie Jarrett. She visited a drug manufacturing plant to get ways to help biotech companies compete in the global market. Biogen CEO George Scango says the administration should consider its tax and regulatory policies.
I think the government needs to think carefully and the administration needs to think carefully about how to balance the need for an appropriate tax structure here with the need for revenues and their other priorities. That will be very important for us. Regulatory issues are important.
The president's Jobs Council has several suggestions for boosting job creation, including training workers for jobs that are tough to fill, streamlining permits for construction projects, easing visa restrictions to boost tourism, and facilitating lending to small businesses. In New York, it is down to the wire for same-sex marriage. With just days left in the current legislative session, attention is focused on four undecided Republican senators. All other senators have committed, with 29 supporting same-sex marriage and 29 opposed. The New York State Assembly has already voted in favor of it. Governor Andrew Cuomo and Mayor Michael Bloomberg have publicly campaigned to legalize gay marriage. At a press conference Monday, the governor used his influence to make a last-minute push.
This is an issue of social justice, in my opinion. This is an issue of social progress. And the Democratic Party has always stood firmly on the side of social progress and rooting out injustice.
Christian clergy leaders in New York will hold a rally on the steps of City Hall today to try and head off efforts to legalize same-sex marriage. A federal court is deciding if it will throw out the ruling that overturned California's Proposition 8 last year. That's the voter-approved ban on same-sex marriage there. Prop 8 supporters are now challenging that ruling because they say the judge had a conflict of interest. Ephraim Graham has the details.
Judge Vaughn Walker ruled the state's ban on gay marriage was unconstitutional last year. And now, after 2 hours of arguments in federal court, a judge must decide if that ruling should stand.
Judges have a duty not only to apply the law without bias, but to do so in a way that avoids even the appearance of impropriety.
Prop 8 sponsor says Judge Walker should have recused himself from the case because of his long-term relationship with another man, and that Walker and his partner stood to benefit from his decision. Gay marriage supporters call the move frivolous.
We have to presume that as a public official, he followed the law. And if he thought that there was a problem, he would have disclosed it.
Judge Walker has since retired from the bench. A decision in this case is expected sometime today. Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
Thanks, Ephraim. The sexting scandal of Congressman Anthony Weiner is just the latest in a long line of public figures caught up in scandal. Every time it happens, the debate reignites over the nature of sex addiction. Is it real, or is it just cheater's excuse? Here's Tyler James.
Congressman Weiner says he's taking a leave of absence to make things better. In order to do that, he's seeking professional help.
I'm trying to make it up to my wife and my family.
It's a storyline Americans are getting all too accustomed to. Powerful men falling to sexual temptation and blaming addiction. Tiger Woods received professional help for his so-called addiction after a very public affair. He says it helps, but is not a cure.
Just because I've gone through treatment doesn't mean it stops. I'm trying as hard as I possibly can each and every day to get my life better and better and stronger.
The big question, is sex addiction real? Some say it's a self-control problem. Others claim it's an actual psychological issue.
We're not talking about people who just like a lot of sex. We're talking about individuals where sex controls their lives.
14 million Americans claim to have a sex addiction. That's one in every 17 adults.
They had two affairs. And I hid them very well. My husband had no idea.
Samantha is a married mother of two who seeks help at a treatment center for her sexual addiction.
I'm Bill.
I'm George.
I'm Mark.
I'm Doug. I'm a recovering sex addict.
The treatment includes a 12-step program and individual and group therapy. Samantha believes her problem is more than a lack of self-control. It's an addiction.
I realized something was more than just early promiscuity in my life when I couldn't stop.
Experts say the internet makes temptation even greater for those with sexual addiction.
It allows for early access, affordable access, and anonymous access. The internet has caused a huge boom in our business, unfortunately. It's the crack cocaine of sex addiction.
For most people, the lack of moral judgment of cheaters is hard to believe, almost idiotic. But as one of the world's most famous cheaters suggests, it's all about ego.
I did something for the worst possible reason, that just because I could.
Tyler James, CBN News.
Turning overseas, Turkey's Islamist-based party has kept its grip on power. Many analysts are concerned Turkey's latest election will lead to a more radical form of Islam there. Chris Mitchell has the story from Istanbul.
This is the one some consider the new strongman in the Middle East, the most powerful leader in the Muslim world, and a politician the U.S. and Israel will have to contend with for at least the next 4 years. His AKP party won 50% of the vote and 325 seats in Turkey's parliament. It gives the AKP a big majority, but not enough seats to independently rewrite Turkey's constitution, their main goal. Many feared if they won enough seats in parliament, they'd rewrite Turkey's constitution and institute Sharia law. But the results do accelerate Turkey's growing influence in the region. With Turkey literally straddling Europe and Asia, the Turks see themselves as a nation of bridges. The government is also building political bridges within the Muslim world, positioning itself to fill a power void left by declining U.S. influence in the Middle East. That's why Erdogan said after Sunday's victory, "Believe me, Sarajevo won today as much as Istanbul. Beirut won as much as Izmir. Damascus won as much as Ankara. Ramallah, Nablus, Jenin, the West Bank, Jerusalem won as much as Diyarbakir." The government insists its agenda is to implement a Western-style democracy. But some see a number of warning signs behind that claim. More journalists are in jail in Turkey than most any other nation, and the government plans to restrict internet use in August. Another concern, the AKP and Erdogan are closely linked to the Fethullah Gulen movement, whose agenda is to achieve world domination through Islam. And Middle East expert Daniel Pipes warned Sunday's election might be the last fair and free ones in Turkey. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Istanbul.
Coming up, every tribe, tongue, and nation. Christians around the world join together as one in prayer.
Have you ever had an idea for an invention or new product? Bill Schaefer, one of the inventors of Wham-O's new Splash Wash, did. He came up with the idea while watching his children play one hot summer afternoon. Bill invented a car wash for kids. Ride through it, run through it. And Ben helped submitted the Splash Wash to Wham-O, the makers of childhood favorites like the Frisbee, Hula Hoop, and Slip and Slide. If you have an invention you would like to try to patent and submit to corporations and want free information that explains how InventHelp may be able to assist you, call now. InventHelp is America's largest invention company with sales offices in over 50 cities nationwide. Call InventHelp today for free information. Bill Schaefer made a financial gain on the Splash Wash. However, most inventions are not successful, and Bill's experience is not typical of what inventors can expect.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-260-7793. That's 1-800-260-7793.
I've fallen and I can't get up. I need help.
When you are home alone and have a bad fall where you cannot move, you are stuck in a very limited area. If you cannot reach a phone, you may lay helpless on the floor for hours or days, which can result in permanent incapacitation or death.
This waterproof pennant is my magic wand. To some of the paramedics, fire department, police, or my doctor, it contacts Life Alert.
When you have a heart attack like I did, and there's no one there, Life Alert was there for me. I couldn't handle the alternative of going to a nursing home.
Thanks to Life Alert, you can live alone without ever being alone. And that's why I wear one.
New Life Alert Classic for seniors or Life Alert 50 Plus.
Please call 1-800-586-0025 for a free brochure about Life Alert. That's 1-800-586-0025. Call us toll-free now at 1-800-586-0025. That number again, 1-800-586-0025.
This week, Christians around the world are going into their communities to serve the needy. The outreach follows this weekend's Global Day of Prayer, which united Christians worldwide. And for the first time, it was hosted in an American city. Ephraim Graham has that story.
Veterans Memorial Arena in Jacksonville, Florida hosted the world's largest prayer gathering. The kickoff event, held on the eve of the Global Day of Prayer, united Christians around the globe by satellite.
Let us right now put our voices together and our hands together and welcome the rest of the world to Jacksonville, Florida!
Global Day of Prayer founder Graham Power set the tone, putting the focus on God.
So this is not about big names, it's not about artists, this is about humbling ourselves and praying.
Then, Jacksonville's pastors took to the stage to lead the world in prayer.
Together with believers all over the world, we gather today to glorify your name You are the creator of heaven and earth. There is no one like you, holy, righteous in all your ways.
They prayed in many languages. Similar scenes took place across the world on Pentecost Sunday. In this town square in Mexico City, Christians prayed to the Lord to stop the violence, kidnappings, and drug trade that is destroying their country. They prayed for 24 hours straight.
We thank the Lord for the revival we are living in Mexico, because in the midst of the difficult situation being experienced by our country, the people of the Lord has risen in prayer, fasting, and crying out in the name of Jesus Christ, so that the times of peace that are promised in the Word come to us.
In the Philippines, the day of prayer fell on the same date as their Independence Day. Christians seize the moment to highlight their spiritual freedom in Christ.
We focus on celebrating our freedom as a country and using that freedom to worship the Lord. But more importantly, we celebrate our freedom in Christ to spread the glory of God, not only in our country, but all over the world.
The Philippines also held the first ever Kids Global Day of Prayer, building up young people to carry the mantle of prayer into the future.
I've learned that today we must pray for other people.
Lord, please take care of the poor people. Please give them homes. Please give them enough food that they could eat.
In Romania, they prayed all day long, asking God for renewal in the church, reform in government and media, and victory over societal evils like abortion and human trafficking.
We need a prayer. Here in Romania, in Europe in special, we need a prayer of righteous people that will come together with us and united your faith with us and believe God to change our nations. May the Lord bless you.
In London, rainy weather forced the celebrations inside. Nevertheless, Christians in 33 boroughs across the city took part. Back in Jacksonville, the Global Day of Prayer passed the baton to church leaders in Jakarta, Indonesia, next year's host city, and wrapped up by proclaiming once more,
"The Spirit and the Bride says, say it with me, amen. Come, Lord Jesus."
Ephraim Green, CBN News.
Up next, the legendary Navy SEALs. We get an inside look at these elite special forces.
What makes the miracles of Jesus even more miraculous? Standing where they happened, in Israel. Come explore Jerusalem, where Jesus opened blind eyes. Visit the hills of Galilee, where Jesus fed the multitude. Stroll through Capernaum, where Jesus lived and taught and healed. To learn more about standing where it all happened, in Israel, visit www.goisrael.com. Come visit Israel.
Are you anxious to protect your family with life insurance, but afraid you can't afford it? Well, look how much insurance many people can get through SelectQuote for less than a dollar a day. SelectQuote found Rich, 37, a $500,000 policy for under $18 a month. Even though Dave, 43, takes meds to control his blood pressure, SelectQuote got him a $500,000 policy for under $28 a month. Ellen, 47, got a $250,000 policy for under $20 a month. All it takes is a phone call. Your personal SelectQuote agent will answer all your questions and impartially shop the highly rated term life companies SelectQuote represents for your best rates. Give your family the security it needs at a price you can afford. Call this number or go to SelectQuote.com. SelectQuote, we shop, you save.
What makes the miracles of Jesus even more miraculous? Standing where they happened, in Israel. Come visit Capernaum, where Jesus restored a paralytic's helpless legs. Sail the Sea of Galilee, where Jesus walked on the water. Stroll through the Garden of Gethsemane, where Jesus healed a servant's ear. To learn more about standing where it all happened, in Israel, visit www.goisrael.com. Come visit Israel.
Since since the killing of Osama bin Laden, the country is fascinated with Navy SEALs. As Chuck Holton found out, many want to know what it takes to be part of their elite team.
The U.S. Navy SEALs are legendary for their toughness and tenacity. These highly trained warriors spend years honing their skills on land, sea, and air. As a former Army Ranger, I wanted to find out if SEAL training was as tough as everyone says. But I'm not about to join the Navy to find out. This is the Extreme SEAL Experience. Situated just outside Norfolk, Virginia, the week-long course gives regular folks a taste of the real thing.
I have to stencil my t-shirt with my last name front and back so I can remember who I am.
I wanted to see if I still had what it takes, so I signed up. 15 others showed up the first day, regular guys from all different backgrounds. A retired Navy SEAL, Senior Chief Don Shipley, runs the program with the help of other former SEALs.
All the instructors are SEALs, and we've all been through Hell Week. We've all done the deployments. We know what it takes to get through that training.
Good morning, ladies.
The Extreme SEAL Experience starts with a surprise wake-up call at 02:30.
2 o'clock in the morning, time to get comfortable being uncomfortable.
I knew a long, hard day was on the horizon.
Back in Ranger school, man.
The week-long course starts with over 24 hours of grueling physical and mental challenges.
All right, it's time to go get on the bus.
The first day of training that we run down here is called Hell Night. It's a simulation of Hell Week and BUDS. Kinda.
BUDS stands for Basic Underwater Demolition School, the six-month training all Navy SEALs must complete. The most intense part? Hell Week. 132 hours that push men past their breaking points, much of it done in the cold ocean water. Most who enter the school drop out during this phase.
If I was running actual SEAL training down here, I'd be back in ambulances in here every day.
The next 24 hours were nonstop action, starting with a 10-mile paddle. Eight men crammed into each boat, and navigating the river in complete darkness was more difficult than I anticipated.
It's a pretty good teamwork exercise, kind of getting to know each other and trying to figure out, how we're going to work together and make this happen.
We ended up in front of a stagnant, algae-infested pond. Then the fun began.
2 foot forward. Move.
Nothing like pond scum for breakfast. But there's a method to the madness. Special operators can't afford to be squeamish.
I get the feeling it's going to get a lot harder from here.
Next came lots and lots and lots of physical training, or PT. It's hundreds of push-ups, sit-ups, flutter kicks, and whatever else the instructors can dream up. The art of camouflage is vitally important, as SEALs must regularly operate behind enemy lines.
How much are they paying me for this?
One, two, three.
And before every new activity, more physical training.
All these guys behind me have come from all over the United States and Canada and paid between $1,500 and $3,000 for a couple weeks of training to find out one thing, and that's if they have what it takes to be a Navy SEAL.
Back straight, heads up. Down.
If the push-ups weren't perfect, we had to start over.
Go.
Log PT is designed to force the men to work as a team under very arduous conditions. The course isn't just about running and push-ups. We also learn some tactical skills, like hand-to-hand combat, and how to transition silently from water to land.
In actual SEAL training, exercises like this are designed to teach these guys what they're capable of and push them beyond their physical limits. And that's why only about 20% of them actually make it to the end of SEAL training.
All right, so we'll hit these two danger crossings.
The highlight of Hell Night is a simulated mission. It's the payoff for all the hard work.
Go, guys, lift her up.
The guys must use all the skills learned throughout the day to complete the operation. These weekend warriors get painted up, paddle downriver under the cover of darkness, hike through dense forest, A small taste of what life must be like as a real Navy SEAL. For these guys, this is better than spending vacation sitting on the beach. The reward is knowing they challenged themselves and made it through. Going back home with a little more self-confidence, some incredible memories, and a greater respect for the sacrifices made by our nation's special operators. Chuck Holton, CBN News, Chesapeake, Virginia.
Millions of women worldwide love Bare Minerals.
This is smooth, it's nice, and it covers. I like that.
Only Bare Minerals looks like beautiful bare skin. Well, it covers whatever you want it to. And now you can get our latest kit with our totally new, totally spill-proof Click Lock Go Foundation. For over 75% off retail, our new kit comes with Bare Minerals Foundation in the shade that's just right for you. Warmth for a healthy glow. Mineral Veil, the ultimate finishing touch. And Bare Minerals Flawless Application Brush. Call now and get three full-size gifts worth $57.95 free. Purchased separately, you'd spend over $120. Our original Get Started Kit was a great deal at two payments of $29.99. But now you can get all this for just one payment of $29.99. Save over $90 and get a 30-day money-back guarantee.
Call 1-800-376-4174. Ask how you can receive this handy compact. Call 1-800-376-4174 now.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now, and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs. And they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding. You don't have to prick your fingers. And some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
And if you call 1-800-284-9762, we will send you a free Betty Crocker Diabetes Cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
The Bible says there is no greater love than for one man to lay down his life for another. And a young boy in Texas did just that. He risked his life for his brother.
We decided to grill some hamburgers and then let the boys swim. And Jaden said there's something wrong with Preston. And then immediately Shelley knew that he was having a seizure.
The Honey family was enjoying a day outside by the pool, and that's when Jaden noticed his brother Preston face down in the water.
He had called for him to come out of the pool and get ready for lunch, and he didn't respond.
I said, "Preston, time to get out of the water." And I just walked down the stairs, swam to him, just turned him over easily. Just let him take a breath.
I don't have the best words for it, but it's just a very proud dad.
He said, thank you for helping me when I'm having a seizure in the water. And then I said, you're welcome.
A little hero there. Like a good brother, Jaden says he will now not let his brother Preston go swimming without him from now on. And that is all for this hour of the CBN News Channel. You can find more of our exclusive coverage of the issues you care most about at cbnnews.com. You can also stay up to date with CBN News through Facebook and Twitter. We hope you join us next time. Have a great day. God bless you.
Have you ever had an idea for an invention or new product? Bill Schaefer, one of the inventors of Wham-O's new Splash Wash, did. He came up with the idea while watching his children play one hot summer afternoon. Bill invented a car wash for kids. Ride through it, run through it. And Ben helped submitted the Splash Wash to Wham-O, the makers of childhood favorites like the Frisbee, Hula Hoop, and Slip and Slide. If you have an invention you would like to try to patent and submit to corporations and want free information that explains how InventHelp may be able to assist you, call now. InventHelp is America's largest invention company with sales offices in over 50 cities nationwide. Call InventHelp today for free information. Bill Schaefer made a financial gain on the Splash Wash. However, most inventions are not successful, and Bill's experience is not typical of what inventors can expect.
For your free inventor's information, call 1-800-260-7793. That's 1-800-260-7793.
Finding video on CBN.com just got easier. We've taken all our video, the 700 Club, news, testimonies, teachings, plus our 24/7 channels, and put them in one convenient location, CBN TV. Watch what you want, when you want. It's all simple to find, and now easier than ever to email a story to a friend. CBN TV on CBN.com.